Hello, Brewtubers. This time, something different. I'm modifying my brewery and adding a little bit of extra space because I ordered some new fermenters, better bottles, all the way from the UK, and I have to store them. I was telling you about the fermenters that I ordered all the way from the UK, and during that video I heard the doorbell, and it was the postman. He brought me the package. The package is over here. Look at this, all the way from the UK, because you can buy them here. It's a package from Homebrew Online in the UK. Then we'll unbox it in a couple of minutes. There's no space left to add more fermenters. No space anymore. So I'm going to add this to the wall. As you can see, I removed the beer sign. It's over there. I need to find the other place for that sign, but I will do that later. Here I have the better bottles, and hopefully I can store them there in the future. So now I will show you something that's homebrew related. Come with me. What we have here is my apple cider. It's sitting in the secondary for 1 week now, and as you can see, it's almost crystal clear. Naturally. Look at this. It's pretty awesome, isn't it? And here we have my mysterious brew. It's fermenting great. Now I'm going to announce what it actually is. It's white grapes juice. So it's actually going to be a white wine, a simple one. And I hope I can show you the fermentation. It's hard to show. But it's alive, that's for sure. And what do we have here? Some glass bottles. Half liter Cooper's bottles. Last Sunday I bottled the Anthem Amber Ale. It's pretty clear though. I have some footage about that bottling day. Just take a look. Here are the bottles. Soaked in some solution from water and sulfite to clean and sterilize the bottles. The fermenter is over there. Let's start bottling. Sanitizing the spigot. I'm always using this bottle filler because it's very handy. It's much more easier than constantly open and close the spigot. It stops floating the beer when you release the valve over there, and it starts floating the beer. Maybe you can see this. The beer level is raising to the neck, and I fill it right off to the top, and then we'll release the bottle. That's too late, but as you can see, it's a nice space left in the bottle. Normally I keg the most of my beers, but not this time because I don't have space enough in my fridge, in my kegerator. So I have the bottle this time. As you can see, my hop plant is growing very well. It grows about 5 or 10 centimeters each day. So that's a quick update on the hops. Say hello to the BrewTubers, Lynn. Yeah, there you go. A couple of minutes ago I showed you some footage about my hop plant. The sun was shining, but not anymore. It's raining again. Well, lucky for me, I have some beer. And I'm inside, so I will stay dry. Most important thing of all, happy Homebrew Wednesday, everybody. Cheers. And remember, nothing is better than a good homebrew. Time to see what's inside this box. I see it's 2 packages. Wow. That's awesome. Oh, that's cool. Look at this. Crystal clear plastic fermenters. So it's safe and easy to handle. It's a 6-gallon fermenter. That's about 23 liters. Look at this. Pretty nice, isn't it? There are 2 markings. I believe this is 3 gallons over here and 6 gallons. So there's a lot of space left. Really nice. Let's see what's inside this envelope. Oh, of course. Some rubber bungs. Did I order 4 of them? I have 4. That's pretty cool. See what I ordered. Ah, I got something free. What do we have more? Some airlocks, also free. Campton tablets for trying to stop the fermentation on the next homemade apple cider. And some O-rings, really nice. This is my shopping haul. Cheers to everybody. This was Homebrew Wednesday, episode 25. Thanks for watching and stay tuned. Cheers.